I still want access to the mountains of data gathered about them when they were children. And at the very least, they want an apology.
I'm aggravated that people are continuing to deny and stonewall and not accept the responsibility for what they did.
Documentary filmmaker Lori Shinseki, along with attorney Barry Coburn, took up their cause.
I think it's incumbent on all of us to take a good, hard, honest look at what happened, and to the extent possible, try and make it right.
In 2013, with the help of that former researcher Larry Perlman, and after 2 years of battles, they broke through the Jewish board's resistance and got some of the records released.
All right. See what happens.
Great to this.
There we go.
It says Philstein. Date of visit 1-10-68. Most of this Philstein goes to the power being tested. This is David.
What did you read in the records?
It's amazing to read some of the stuff about what you were thinking or saying when you were a little kid. It's strange.
Dr. Bernard, the consultant who advised breaking up twins for adoption, told journalist Lawrence Wright in the 1990s she only favored separating twins who had not had time to develop a strong attachment to each other.
Because then we would be traumatically separating those who had an opportunity to be attached to each other.
So even the doctor who was saying twins are better if they're raised separately was saying if they've had this thing called the twinning reaction, don't separate them.
Correct.
Because it's traumatic.
Yes, in her own words.
But as they sift through their records, Doug and Howard discovered Dr. Bernard didn't even follow her own rule. It turns out Doug and Howard were together for 6 months before being separated and adopted to different families.
For the first 6 months of your life, the only consistent thing in either of your lives was each other.
That is what they did was really, really wrong. And the more, you know, stuff I read, the more wrong it kind of seems, and the more upsetting it gets.
In page after page, Doug and Howard's records reveal harrowing details of the stress and trauma they endured after their separation.
Well, it's pretty disturbing. People sitting around with us after a year of life.
One researcher wrote about Doug and Howard, clinically referred to as C5 and C6. Following adoption, both boys show a decline in motor dexterity. Both also begin walking after adoption, with C5 walking for a longer period of time than C6. C5 also shows head banging, which continues until his second birthday.
It's upsetting to know that these people were able to affect our lives in a way that I didn't even understand. And I don't even know why I can't think about it, but it's just, it's not really my nature, but it's just hard to, I'm not really introspective, and when you start looking, you start going, wow, maybe that didn't happen. You know, maybe some of the hard spots wouldn't have been hard. I don't know.
They didn't give a damn for anybody, only what they were doing, their work.